Thank you. Thank you very much for your kind introduction. It's a great pleasure to be here. Thank you all for coming. And of course, it's a great honor to be speaking here on what I think is the true one and only road marking conference in the world. And Thorsten, you're right. Before joining Van Velsen in the road marking industry, I used to work at the largest childcare company of the Netherlands and employing roughly 6,000 co-workers, of which probably 99.8% women, all women of a certain young age. And currently I'm working at Van Velsen, just over 100 co-workers, of which roughly 98% men. Grumpy old men, mostly. So you can imagine which I'd like better. Now, to be honest, I think the road marking industry is absolutely very interesting, and I've had a great joy over the past 3 years in working at Van Velsen. Van Velsen, the leading road marker of the Netherlands since 1935. We've been in business for over 85 years and are the number one road marking company in the Netherlands. We currently, as I said, employ over 100 co-workers. We have 30 squads out on the roads every day, and we cover literally every corner of the country, from the islands up north of the country and all the way down onto the Belgian border. We have three main shareholders. Those are the biggest infrastructure construction companies of the Netherlands, and they have a combined total revenue of roughly 16 billion euros. So we have really some big partners in the Netherlands as well. In the past, we used to work in Africa as well and in the Caribbean, but currently we purely focus on the Netherlands. Before I continue, there's the European Media Services Directive, which gives the obligation in audiovisual contents to provide warnings on commercial content. And just to be clear, I might be positive about the Firma Hoffmann, which might be quite cumbersome some working with. Now, just kidding, Jan, we definitely do like working with yourselves and Hoffmann and some other parties that I will be displaying in the presentation. But nothing of that is sponsored. It's all based on my own experience, which is quite positive. Well, coming to my presentation. The road marking squeeze in the Netherlands. A challenging environment with increasing sustainability demands under big margin pressure. Just to set the scene a little bit. The Netherlands, just a small country, 8 times smaller than Germany, 16 times smaller than France. And actually, I stopped counting when I reached 30 road marking companies in the Netherlands. So there's quite a bit of competition going on there. Another interesting challenge, of course, is climate change. Although COP26 over the recent weeks in Glasgow didn't reach major big new agreements, in 2015, 195 countries around the world signed the Paris Agreement. And of course, the Dutch government was one of them. And that's all aimed to reduce global warming by 1.5 degrees Celsius by 2050, which means large reduction of greenhouse gases, which is mandatory to that. And I live in a rural part, as Thorsten mentioned. I have, and this is a small sidestep, I have many dairy farmers as neighbors, and often when I discuss with them the threats of global warming and the fact that tens of thousands of species will become extinct in the next couple of decades, they tell me, well, Emil, that's not a real big deal. You see, the glaciers have disappeared from the Netherlands, and that has meant a lot of improvement here. The dinosaurs have become extinct already millions of years ago, and still look around you how beautiful the Earth looks. So the fact that global warming is taking place, they often think that is not a really big deal. Well, that's one way to look at it. But unfortunately, we have customers, and one of them is the Dutch Road Authority. And the Dutch Road Authority is responsible for the maintenance of all highways in the Netherlands. And where the Paris Agreement has laid down some challenges for 2050, they've come up with the ambition to be fully climate neutral by 2030. Imagine, that is just 8 years from now. So that is really a challenging ambition. And coming back to my neighbors, of course we could follow their strategy and just like the ostrich, put our heads in the sand and say, well, let's see what happens in 2030. But Van Velzen, the leading road marker in the Netherlands since 1935, of course, this would not be our strategy. So we decided to go full straight ahead and still believe that the attack would be still the best defense with these changes coming on our path. So basically, this meant we also changed our ambition. From being the leading road marker in the Netherlands, we have rephrased our ambition and said we want to be basically the leading road marking company of the world. We want to be the most innovative and sustainable road marking company in the world. And yes, you might think that's quite a bold statement, indeed, for such a small road marking company in such a small country. But bear in mind, the Dutch national team that went to Tokyo this summer for the Tokyo Olympics, they ranked 7th overall. So of the 195 competing countries in Tokyo, the Dutch ended up 7th. So yes, it is a bold statement, but I think still, as a small country and a small company, we can achieve this. But, well, that brings indeed some challenges. The costs of investments had to become zero, reach zero emission by 2030 are huge. And combine that with the huge competition that we face in the Netherlands with over 30 road marking companies, there's a high risk that margins and profitability will end up somewhere below zero. And that's a high risk. And of course, we want to exist for another 85 years. So, it was Harry Leavitt who already wrote a paper in 1964 where he displayed the framework of people, process and technology for organizational change. And that's what we looked at. And although it was Heraclitus, the famous Greek philosopher, who already said 2,500 years ago, change is the only constant in life, I must say there hadn't been much change with Van Velzen in the past previous, let's say, 25 years. So this means taking these big steps was really a quantum leap step for Van Velzen, which we needed to address in a holistic approach. We couldn't just say, let's invest in some climate-neutral equipment and then we're done. That would definitely mean that in the previous picture that we probably would be in the wake of bankruptcy in a couple of years' time. So we started looking at our people first. And unfortunately, we had to let go quite a number of them. In order to make that quantum leap step, we had to look at our people and say, are you able to join us in this new journey that we will take? But thankfully, the vast majority remained. And another important element in working with our people was that we had to change the way we worked with our staff. Traditionally, we had a way of working where very top-down, we would tell people what to do, how to do it, and when to do it. But if you want to drive innovation, if you want to drive change, you'd need every resource in your company. So, being aware of the significance of employee empowerment, this is what we've been doing and trying over the past 3 years, is really to empower our staff. Since I truly believe that it enhances the trust and belief of the employees as well, which is necessary for creativity and innovation, which in the end will drive organizational growth. So that was really a change in the way we used to work together in our company. Coming to processes, this is basically how our offices look like. 3 years ago. Huge piles of paper, a lot of people, and we also had to look at our processes. It was not just about equipment, it was just not like people, as I showed in the diagram from Livit's paper. We really had to look at the processes, and we worked together with quite a number of software vendors in the Netherlands, specific Dutch vendors tailored to the Dutch situation, and we nearly automated every process within the company. And to give you a small impression, this is basically how the office looks like these days. That's quite a change. Now, of course, this is a little bit exaggerated, but indeed, all the piles of paper have gone, and people are really now looking at big screens and monitoring processes instead of producing piles of paper. So on the process part and on the people part, we worked together with a number of specific Dutch companies, but specifically also on the technology side, we found some very good partners specifically in the road marking industry. Because I believe, of course, if you want to innovate, this is not something that you can do by yourself. If you want to become world leader, you have to find the right partners to support you, and partners that have the same ambition. The same ambition to be the world leading in their field of expertise. So one of the first partnerships we signed was with Tiger, a small startup company in the Netherlands who is world leading in GPS location services. But we didn't just buy a robot from them. We really entered into a partnership with a mutual interest and mutual benefit both to our business as well as to the business of Tiger. Not just buying a robot and start working with it, but really also working together in how can we change and adapt our processes towards new technology. Not just do what you always did with some new tools, but really how can we change and improve our existing processes. And we're still in that partnership, and I think from both sides we have a lot of fun with it. Another partnership deal we signed with Swarco. Of course, very much known to all of you, Swarco the Netherlands. Of course, they bring in all their product knowledge, and we have brought in our 85 years of experience and knowledge of the Dutch market and application. And together we've been working to new solutions towards the Dutch market. Very interesting. And I think Swarco is here present today as well, and you can find them in booth number 13, if I'm not mistaken. And they probably will be able to tell you a bit more about our cooperation. And basically, that also applies to Tiger, present here today and present in booth number 35. Again, this is not a commercial presentation, but I do like mentioning them because we really enjoy working with them. And finally, last but definitely not least, we entered into a good partnership. Jan, this quality of the... with Hoffman. The benchmark in service, the benchmark in quality. As mentioned, in our ambition to be world leading road marking company, we need to work with world leading companies like Hoffman. And I truly think Hoffman is absolutely the standard in road marking industry in the world. And we have worked together over the past years in a couple of very nice new things. And actually, when I put down my presentation, I put in some examples that I wanted to share with you. But the good thing about partners is that you live and breathe a bit like the same thing. So I found out when I saw the schedule that basically the things that I put in my presentation, that the Firma Hoffman has also put them into the practical demonstrations this afternoon. So we definitely had the same views and ideas about that. Last year we've been piloting a lot the zero emission H9E sprayable cold plastic machine. In our ambition to become zero emission, of course, this is a great step forward. It's a great machine, great quality of road markings, absolutely very nice. And it will be in the practical demonstration, I think, at the end of the show this afternoon. In 2019, there was also a demonstration at the practical demonstration here with one of our H33 machines, stage 5. This is a new one, will also be demonstrated here this afternoon. And basically, I said 4 lines in one pass. I think it's even 6 different line markings that can be done with this machine in one pass. Just one touch of the button, and that means, of course, a lot of efficiency in our processes. Jan Hofman just demonstrated the swiveling cold plastic machine as a new feature. Well, we have quite a number of swiveling thermoplastic machines, and I must say our operators, they really love them. Another thing that we were the first with to implement at Van Velzen with Hofman was the telemetry module, and it's currently fitted on all our H18, H26 and H33 machines. And I can tell you there are quite a bit of them. And this gives us real-time data on engine performance as well as on all the road markings applied. It's also, again, something that is new and led to new processes internally. Coming back to the title of my presentation, the road marking squeeze, the high competition, and the urge for all the investments, and the risk that bears for our profitability. So what happened with our investments? They quadrupled over the past 3 years. Compared to our investment levels of the previous 15 years, our investments have quadrupled. And of course, a lot of associated costs and the cost of depreciation bears a risk of our profitability dropping below zero. So the question is, I guess you're all wondering, did it pay off? Did the transformation of the company work, and where did we end with these huge investments that we made? Well, I can tell you, despite the fact that we quadrupled our investments, our net profit has increased by 10% point. Not just 10%, but 10% point. So our net profit went from 3% to 13%. Whilst making all these huge investments. So my message to you all would be, investing in sustainability measures, investing in carbon-free equipment pays off, as long as you make sure you take the holistic approach, really transform your company, don't continue to work the way you used to work, find some good partners, share the ideas that make use of the ideas that we worked out with our partners. They're all commercial parties, not paying me for this presentation, but of course you pay them when you buy their solutions. But they're of course available to all of you. The things that we think and come up with our partners are not exclusively for us. They're available to all of you. So. That basically ends my little presentation. If you'd like to learn more about how to climb mountains and run mountains in the Alps, or how to reach new goals with your company in investing in sustainability, please look me up afterwards, and thank you for your attention.